Hi, welcome to my eMath online classes. My name is Yugandhar, mathematics lecturer. Now we are discussing the topic locus. Take a look at the question. This is problem number 3 in academy textbook. Find the locus of a point such that the distance from origin is twice the distance from P to capital A 1, 2. Before answering this question, we have to get a clear picture about this problem. It's very important. Solve the question. Now we are making some ideas about this question. Now write down the first step. In this topic locus, we have to give as a first step as a let P x1 y1 be any point in locus. Any point in locus. This is the first step you have to give in this entire topic. Later you have to identify if any point was given in the entire question. If so, you have to mention that point too. After observing the question, we have two points more are there in the question. The one of them is origin and the other one is capital A 1, 2. Let us mention these points too. Write down given points. So since it is origin, we have to write O 0, 0. Okay. And the other one, capital A 1, 2. According to scenario, he says the distance from origin, what we can say about this distance from origin can be represented as OP. Okay, fine. OP. Distance from origin, we can write OP. So, according to the problem, we can write OP. That is nothing but distance from origin. And later he says is equal to distance from origin is OP. Is means equal to. Now here what we are doing here is we are converting English into mathematics. Okay. Now distance from origin is OP. Is means equal to. Later he says twice means double. Sometimes he says double, twice, okay, or he can also says two times. All those things is representing the same. That is, we have to multiply the next things with a two. That is the indication. Okay. Now, twice means two. Fine. The distance from P to A. So we can represent that thing, distance from P to A as PA. Fine. Is there any doubts? You can comment. Okay, fine. So now OP equal to 2 into PA. Is it clear? Later, OP means a distance, and we already have an idea about the distance. Okay, I am giving the formula for distance. Suppose two points we are having, one of them is x1, y1 and the other one is x2, y2. Okay, x2, y2. Then the distance between the points is represented as AB, and the formula for this is x2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole square. Okay, give a complete square root. So this is the formula we are using for distance for here left hand case and right hand case. Now OP means O is origin 0 0, so consider this O origin 0 0 as x2 y2, and the point P is, we already know it is x1 y1, so I am mentioning this point as x2 y2. For the left hand case, so take a square root, x2 minus x1, that means x2 stands for 0, look at here, 0, and x1 is x1, so 0 means 0 minus x1 whole square plus 0 minus y1 whole square. Is it clear? Next equal to next 2, and again take a square root. Now we are going to create a PA. PA means distance between the points P and A. Here in this situation, we are considering the point capital A 1 comma 2 as x2 y2. Right. Now, according to the formula, distance formula, x2 minus x1 whole square. x2 stands for 1, minus x1 is x1. 1 minus x1 whole square plus y2 stands for 2, y1 is y1. So 2 minus y1 whole square. Clear? Now, I am clearing this one also. Now, take a look at both of the sides. Do squaring on both sides. Do squaring on both sides, because to remove the square roots on both of the sides, we have to do squaring on both sides. This will remove the square roots. So we have just 0 minus x1 whole square plus 0 minus y1 whole square is equal to, here we are doing squaring on both of the sides, mathematical operation. Then 2 becomes, this 2 becomes 2 square, because we are squaring on both sides. Okay, take a bracket, and this square root is already removed because we are doing squaring. So what left here? 1 minus x1 whole square plus 2 minus y1 whole square. Fine. 0 minus x1 is nothing but x1 square, because negative square is positive, x1 square is x1 square. Similarly, here also we have y1 square is equal to 2 square means 4. Here in this term, 1 minus x1 whole square, we are using a minus b whole square. A square minus 2ab, 2ab plus b square. Again, we have to use the same formula, a minus b whole square. For 2 minus y1 whole square, 2 square minus 2ab, 2 into 2 into y1 plus y1 square. Fine. Next, x1 square plus y1 square equal to 4 of 1 square is 1 minus 2x1 plus x1 square plus 2 square is 4, 2 2's are 4y1, okay, plus y1 square. Next step, x1 square plus y1 square equal to 4 into 1, 4 minus 4 2's are 8x1. We are multiplying with 4 in the entire terms in the bracket. 4x1 square, 4 4's are 16, again 4 4's are 16y1 and 4y1 square. For getting next step, it is suggested to move this left-handed sided terms, x1 square, y1 square into right-hand side. This is very easy for us. Okay, so 4 minus 8x1 square, 8x1 plus 4x1 square plus 16 minus 16y1 plus 4y1 square. Here, these are the terms. Minus x1 square, minus y1 square. Fine? Can you all understand this? Okay, fine. 4x1 square minus x1 square. How much it was? 3x1 square. Later, find out the y1 square terms. Here, two terms exist. 4y1 square and minus y1 square. How much? 3y1 square. Okay? Later, find out the x terms. It is just minus 8x1. And next, find out the y1 terms. It is just minus 16y1. And now, find out the constant terms. 4, two terms exist. 4 and 16. Plus 4 and plus 16, nothing but 20. Which is equal to 0. You can change equal to sign like this also. Now the locus is, therefore, this is the final step. Locus is, just replace x1 with x. So 3x1 square becomes 3x square and 3y1 square become 3y square, because this is a generalization. So we are doing so. 8x1 become 8x, 16y1 become 16y plus 20 equal to 0. Here it is the answer for this question.